I'm Craig Portinga, and we own a company called Walrite Foundations. Walrite Foundations has been in existence since 1994. I took over ownership of the business in 2008 from my dad, so we're second generation now at this point. We do mainly residential foundations. We do also some commercial work as well too, and we don't do any flat work. We just specialize in the footing and the foundation element of the construction. You know, dealing with the things that we dealt with on the job site, foundations were becoming very detailed. The custom homes were becoming more and more complicated to build and put down. One of the elements that we deal with in Colorado here are they're called caissons. So we're not putting a footing down, we're drilling a hole in the ground. A mistake on those is costly. We had layouts that were done wrong, and that was one of the motivating reasons to get to the robotic total station was to try to minimize our human error. We would see survey crews function on our job sites, and there was one special occasion where a certain survey crew was using a piece of equipment that didn't involve two people talking to each other. Something brand new to me, but I was watching this head spin and move and follow this guy as he was down laying out points in our excavation. And at that point in time, I thought that was neat, and that would be something that I would love to learn how to do and apply it to this job, because he was doing something for us that I could have been doing for myself. So I thought, hey, that's neat. Let's see if we can figure out whose equipment that was and kind of get something put in place. So for the last few years, we had been going to the World of Concrete. And I thought if there's not a better place to find that technology, it would be at that trade show. So the year that we went, it would have been probably 2013. That year, that was our main goal, was to work through the companies that sold those kind of robotic total stations. And when I went there, my goal was to have the company be able to take one of my plans and put it into their software, because that was one of the elements that concerned me, was taking and getting what we needed to go and get it to work in our on our job site. So we challenged several companies on the World of Concrete floor to do that for us. And they said, if you can get us a DWG file of your plan, we'll do it for you. Well, the next day I surprised them and I had a DWG file emailed to me from a structural engineer. And I said, here we go. Can you show me how to do this? And Leica came through. And in less than 20, 30 minutes, I think it took us longer just to establish a hotspot, get an email sent over. And from there, they were able to load it up into their system in Icon, and we were set up in a tablet and we were ready to do layout on the floor at the World of Concrete. So we were not an easy sell. We thought we were really good with tape measures and strings. We did well with that. So when Leica was telling us that their accuracy was within 2 millimeters, really dependent upon how well you can hold the rod, and the experience that we had had with those in the survey world being an inch, inch and a half off, we weren't really convinced that this was the way to go. So two individuals from Leica came out. They brought equipment out. And we had set the stage the day before, and we had poured a footing, and we had the footing completely stripped, forms are off, ready for the Leica people to come out and show us how the equipment ran. And we put extra attention into that footing. We wanted to make sure it was right.
My name is David. I'm the wall foreman here at Walrite, and I was one of the biggest skepticals for using the Leica. I was the one that was in charge of squaring the walls, so I would be running the tape measures, running the strings, setting everything up, and there's a lot of responsibility on me. When Leica came out to work on the job with us, I was the one that was punching the squares from one corner of the foundation to the other corner to make sure that what they were giving us was right. When we were going from the different elevations from top of the wall on one side to the lower elevation on the other side, we would always punch a diagonal, and then we'd punch another diagonal with the elevation change to make sure that we were setting things right.
We were down there with our pouches on, tape measures, We were running strings and pulling measurements off of the points that they were leaving behind, and it was perfect. It was spot on. There was no worries up and down on elevation. They could transfer from the garage foundation down to the basement elevation with ease, where they went to every corner of that foundation with purpose. There was no walking from one spot of the hole to the next to pull a tape measure, reel it back up and pull another distance. They went around, marked all these things out. And when we finally got to the point where we could pull one of the longest squares on the footing, and we pulled that measurement, and it was within an eighth of an inch. I mean, you could adjust the tape physically and go either way. It was spot on. We were impressed. We were sold at that point that they had the technology, they had the equipment to be accurate. But yet, Leica wisely told us, check everything you do with this equipment until you feel comfortable that you're good. So we did that for a week or less, and we realized we were wasting our time, that we were so much quicker and so much more efficient with the product and precise, that we knew this was the best way to go. Dealing with the cold and the snow, oh, it's an expensive piece of equipment, you can't put it outside. No, you can. We've actually ran the equipment in elements. Obviously, it's raining, like you need an umbrella that bad, then you know, don't put your stuff out there, cover it up. But layouts work. The tablet screens deal with moisture. They deal with the cold. They deal with the heat. So you're not held back going outside with equipment like this. It works. And it works, I touched on that a little bit, but it works consistently well in all the elements. Whether the sun's shining right into your prism and you can't make connection, right there's a change. You can change the application and go to bright sun, shadows, clouds. You can deal with the elements within your own tablet itself to make all that work.
Another thing that I thought was really neat was, because I was always so particular, if a framer came back to us and said, your foundation was out of square, I would be the one that would say, I think the framer is doing something wrong. So I would go to the framers and I would show them how we squared it. And every time a framer would square something different than how we would square a wall, they would end up a little bit different using their tapes. After we had the foundation poured, we could go back and give them the points they needed to frame their wall. This was especially helpful on the large and difficult foundations. So that again helped overall in the process of giving the builder what they wanted and giving an overall better product.
So the builder's response was amazing. And builders talk to each other. They're not too willing to share trades sometimes, but the communication builders had, I'd start getting phone calls from other trades, home builders, saying, hey, we got a real complex custom home coming up. Can you come do this for us? And it opened up more work for Walrite. Walrite was already busy. So one of the things I offered was, I can't come do the work, but I can come do the layout for the foundation crew. If they're willing, I'll be happy to come out and do that. And I'll do it all the way through their whole sequence of construction. I won't just leave them some offset stakes and walk away. I'll make sure that they get all the way through their foundation pour using this equipment. And the builders love that. And they insisted that their foundation guys used us to do it. So we did that for several foundation contractors alone. We would go out and do their footing and their foundation layouts, and we were charging them to do it. So even though we couldn't produce the foundation because we were already at max capacity, yet I was able to take out a piece of equipment and go do the layouts for these guys. And we've increased our bottom line just by doing more work for other people that way as well too. Once we got over that hump and we figured out that this is where we want to go, we fully commit, let's give it a shot, let's go with it. The savings were realized instantaneously. The very next day, we went out in layout to go lay out for future footings. And that morning alone, we'd had three layouts to do. And I was able to accomplish all three layouts before noon by myself, with tape strings and doing it that way. It's very, very hard to do it by yourself. It's very time consuming. Two guys is great. Three guys is even better. One guy to run the calculations off the plan. So right away, we realized the savings in manpower that was there and the speed by which you could lay out your footing, your foundation. And the accuracy was there right away. And those are the things that set the stage for your productivity, your resulting income. That same day on the third footing, we changed our sequence. We changed how we do things. I went to go do a layout on a footing and realized the excavation wasn't correct. We had to get an excavator out there to fix it. And if we would have done it the old way, the way we had been doing it, we would have realized that error in excavation too late, and we would have lost a footing pour that day. And in the way we schedule things, we're doing a complete unit a day, we would have lost a unit on our schedule that would have pushed us back. Well, labor rates at that time were $8,000 to $9,000 plus your material, everything that's involved there. So there's money lost. That's not recognized income for the day. So you're saving on your personnel, you're saving on your efficiency, speed in the field, and on job loss, just with those parts of it alone. So one other concern that we had purchasing this product was support. We're gonna have problems in the field, just the nature of the game. So there were several occasions, I would say at that point, it was mostly me just going through process. Why isn't this working? Why am I not connecting to the robot? It was fixed quickly within 5 to 10 minutes. And there was at least two occasions where I needed to call the Leica support. And I had a very capable person jump online with me. And, you know, it was before the day of doing a screen share or any of those kind of things. We're out in the field. So we're just talking over the phone. They understood what I was saying, and we were able to make the connection work. It's just until you actually see the product work and experience the benefits in the field, then you realize the gain in your value for what it can produce. I never realized it until we started working with it. You just have to get it. You have to try it and use it, and it works great.